for Miado to find that range. He's got a little bit of a reach on Daniel, and he's gonna wanna put that jab out there and stay nice and tight. He's gotta be careful of that right hand, though.
Yeah.
Dean steps in here.
Caught him in the groin there, just an inadvertent catch. Daniel's just shaking it out, giving him a few seconds, and then they're back at it.
Here we go. 3 5-minute rounds, and again, judged as a whole as opposed to round by round in this MMA battle between Miado and Williams. Williams ranked number 5 coming in.
Good level change there early on from Nate as he's throwing those feints.
Jeremy Miado's doing a good job of managing this range, though.
The experience advantage is going to have to go to Jeremy Miado.
Right hand touched him.
Yeah, it did. Straight right, and then responding with a straight left is Miado. Miado with a heavy right.
Miado looks fast early on. That jab.
A little 1-2 from Miado there. Outside leg kick responded to Williams with
that.
A straight right. Oh, and another 1-2 Miado. Touched him on the chin with the right.
It's the looping right hand of AT versus those beautiful straight punches. Woo! That uppercut, though.
Touched him on the chin. Miado, and now Williams wisely gets into the clinch here with his back up against the fence.
I'm just going to say this, that if this round continues like this, it's going to be a tough one to judge because these guys are touching each other with some power.
Here's the first takedown attempt by Miado. Miado's grappling is underrated. I've seen him work with a lot of high-level wrestlers and grapplers out there at Rock Force, and he's been looking sharp lately. Gets that body lock, ends up in side control for Mini T. This is the first test Mini T's really going to see on the ground, Rich. I know you spoke about it.
Absolutely. This is where we're going to see what Mini T's made of in MMA, but you talked about it right. Like, Miado has been underrated, particularly in the grappling category. But I'll tell you, you've seen some great grappling with him when, like, in his match against Mao Tao and against Adiwang. He looked great on the ground, and this is exactly what I said his path of least resistance to winning this match would be.
Yeah, he changed up his game plan pretty quick after a couple of those right hands. Even though he was landing on the feet, I like this change of strategy. Easy pass, the half guard here, steps over into full mount. Miado is in complete control. You can see Williams tried to hit bump to create that space and that escape, but he might give up his back in the process. You gotta keep your arms real tight. You don't wanna start extending your arms and start reaching for things if you're Williams.
Yeah, I don't think Miado's gonna look for a submission here. He's looking to pin an arm down, get him in a position where he can just land some punches, do a little bit of ground and pound.
Mini T needs those Tyrannosaurus Rex arms. You need to keep your arms nice and tight to your body and then start pushing off your opponent so you can create that space. When you're on top and doing damage, you don't want that space. On the bottom, you need to create that movement, and that's what that space gives you.
2 minutes to go here in round one in this MMA battle. Mini T on his back. Miado looking to unload with his barrage of punches. Saw him throw a few rights a moment ago.
Good job to get that underhook. Now he's going overhook on the other side, but Miado was wise to it. Sucks in the arm, pins it down. He's trying to pass into half, but beautiful job by Daniel Williams to not only retain full guard, but then to get his back up against the wall so he can start working his way back up.
Using that wall to his advantage, Mini T. Desperate to get back on his feet.
He's got to be a little bit more technical here, trying to work his way back up. See how he's trying to do these big motions, but he does. One big motion, he gets back up to his feet, but Miado's going to drag him back down here.
Mini T finds that fence again, though, with his back. On home base here for Mini T, just in desperation, finally able to get out of this, and they return to the center of the one circle to trade strikes in the final minute of round one.
This is important when they came off the break like that. Miado.
Oh, there he goes. Mini T takes a knee. Miado on top. Miado unloading rights. Is this it for Daniel Williams?
Good resiliency shown by Williams. Let's see if he can survive the round here.
There's a knee to the head of Williams as he gets back on his feet. Wow. Takes a straight right.
There's swinging and banging. That right hand hurt Miado as well.
Miado throwing everything right now. Now knees from both men. Bloody nose. Mini T, but he continues to stand in the pocket and throw strikes.
Look at Miado throwing the spinning elbows.
Back and forth they go.
This is crazy. Miado's learning the Mini T that wouldn't go away when he fought Raw Tag. This is exactly the resilience we were talking about earlier, Mitch.
As advertised, Miado and Williams, as Miado goes to the air for the flying knee.
Flying knee, Miado didn't land it. Mini T stays in there, blood streaming down his face.
Oh,
bang time overhand right. From Jeremy Jeremy Miado. This final minute has been sensational. But he continues to stand in a trade,
yeah,
straight
look at
right.
The left side of his face.
He's going to throw a right hand like that. He needs to step in and actually commit to that thing. Otherwise, he's going to be standing right in Miado's range for a leg kick or a counter right of his own.
Miado with a 1-2 there. Nice right from Miado.
You got to wonder how many he recovered from that massive right hand thrown by Miado in the first five.
It wasn't just the right hand, but keep in mind, Miado followed up with the knee.
Yes. Yeah. It was like right in his path. Perfect. Opportunity to throw a knee while his opponent was on the ground. Nice counter punch there from Mini-T.
Perfectly legal in one championship.
Absolutely. Inside leg kick, Miado. We've seen a couple of those early on in the first minute of the second round from Jeremy Miado trying to take down the fifth ranks, Danial Williams.
Going back to those leg kicks would be a good idea for Mini T too. Miado's got that wide stance. He's also stopped some of that explosiveness and movement that's coming from Miado right now. Daniel's doing a good job of creating the angles though.
Yeah, but he's walking right into Miado's range and just being right at the tip of the punches and allowing himself to get hit or clipped on the way in.
You see how he's circling to the power side too? He just keeps moving to the other side, maybe trying to cut those angles off of Miado. But he's got to mix, he's at a slight disadvantage when it comes to the boxing, it seems.
Andy T looking to counter, a feint there, 320 in round two. Again, inside leg kick from Miado. 1-2 Miado, counter attack from Mini T. Mini T going for the body, wild left hook there.
Yeah, that was good, that was a good change of things. He's kind of just headhunting on Miado, who's got really good eyes and really good reactions and head movement. Going after the legs and going after the body is smart money.
Inside,
for Mini T.
Yeah, inside, then doubled up on the outside leg kick, did Mini T.
Yeah, Miado has found Mini T's rhythm at this point in time. And so right there, you see he landed another right hand. I love the way that Mini T was throwing those kicks before, and he needs to keep doing that because that's stuff that Miado hasn't picked up on yet. That's how he's going to score.
Mini T working those legs, as you said, mixing it up, Mitch.
Yeah, he's got to do that. He can't just stand here. He's got to utilize all the weapons. You don't want to box with Jeremy Miado because boxing is what he wants you to do with him. He wants to stand there and trade hands with you. But Mini T's creating some angles, but he's got to start firing those leg kicks. Keep those things coming, and don't throw them blind, too. Don't just throw one leg kick like he just did. He's got to put the punches in front of it and then throw that leg kick.
Yeah, but prior to that leg kick, he walked right into range, and Miado was able to land a jab and then another 1-2 right after it.
Blood coming from the eyes and the nose here of Danial Williams. Final 2 minutes, second round. 3 5-minute rounds. Judge as a whole. Body kick there from Mini T.
Yeah, now Mini T's starting to utilize those kicks. That's where he needs to go.
Come
utilize that world-class Muay Thai experience that he's got and start the movement of Jeremy Miado. The explosiveness that comes out of Miado is generated a lot by his lower body, and beating on the legs is going to be a good way to slow down some of that movement from Miado.
Left hook to the face there from Miado. And a straight right counter by Mini T. 90 seconds in round two.
Mini T gets into problems when he stands right in front of him. When he's moving, when he gets in and then he gets out, he's out of that range. But once Miado finds that range, boom, right there. That's when he needs to start moving.
You know, Miato's only got a 2-inch reach advantage on Mini T, but that is enough for Mini T to be able to just walk into that range and Miado pick at him the way that he's been doing this match.
But the way that Miado kind of turns his shoulders and extends.
Oh, there he goes. Miado, but back to his feet. Mini T says, I'm okay, but he takes a left hook. And then another left.
He's in
and
trouble.
A right hook.
He's in trouble.
Miado has got him in trouble.
Oh, turns him into a wrestler. Look at Jeremy Miado touching
he's not on steady legs.
Right hook again. He's thrown about 5 hooks as Miado. Yeah, an overhand right.
Miato's being very patient here. This is very smart. He's not swinging wild.
Snaps it.
He's not
going
to allow Mini T to catch him.
I mean, Miado bringing a barrage of everything, a straight right.
Mini T has
left
got
hook.
A chin. He is ultra tough. Rotang couldn't get him out of there, but Jeremy Miado is hitting him from some serious angles with power.
I love the way that Miato's picking his combinations right now. He hit him with that two-piece and then backed off. He didn't try to keep going there. He knows, even when Mini T is hurt, that he's dangerous.
He is snapping that jab to good effect here in the later stages of round two. Mini T continues to try to walk him down there. One final round, 5 minutes to go in this MMA battle, catchweight battle between Miado and the fifth-ranked Mini-T, Danial Williams.
Yeah, you said it in the second round, Rich, that Miado's looking very patient. He's composed. He's not going all out. He's just picking his shots continually, looking for those.
Miado knocked him down. Miado on the attack. That's it. Herb Dragon. Incredible stuff.
Yeah, Jeremy Miado has found a new level and put it on display. Look at those boxing combinations. Down the middle, little angles, uppercuts, hooks. Spectacular display by the Jaguar. Look at that, Rich.
Two-piece, he throws the two-piece, then he pauses, angles off, and then throws another two-piece.